Hi, Wolowu here. It's been a while since my last video. Over a year, actually. In the time since then, I've discovered something that has taken my backgrounds to another level. It's quick, it's easy, and most importantly, it's free. Because that's why you're here, isn't it? If you haven't seen my other tutorial already, I would suggest giving it a watch to get you up to speed on how to make your own custom 3D backgrounds for comics, webtoon, manga, and illustrations. Or don't. It's up to you. Other than that, let's get right into it. Just like last time, we're going to be using Blender. If you don't know how to use the software, there are literally thousands of tutorials out there, so I'm sure you'll be able to figure it out very quickly. I've already talked about the Archimesh add-on I used in the previous tutorial, and I'm still going to be using it here to make a basic room. Because this time, it's not the foundation of the room we'll be focusing on, but rather the decorating of the room. You know, stuff like furniture, wallpaper, flooring, and little trinkets to make the place feel alive. In my last video, I said that you'd have to model these things yourself, but I realized that that's not actually true at all. This is where the Blender Kit add-on comes into play. It's basically a huge library where you can search for exactly what you're looking for and simply drag it into your scene. It's made collectively by the Blender community, and here's the best part. Everything that's posted on here is either licensed as royalty-free or Creative Commons Zero. If these terms are unfamiliar to you, it basically means that you are allowed to use it commercially and not have to pay any royalties, and you also don't have to credit the creators of an item if you use it. This makes sense because typically a 3D scene will use tens or even hundreds of different items, so it'd be impossible to keep track of the creators of everything. The only thing you're not allowed to do, specifically with the items that are not CC0, is that you can't sell them somewhere else as 3D models. I.e. don't export it and post it on ArtStation, because you didn't make it. Which is great news for us, because we weren't planning on doing that anyways, right? Around here, we respect the copyrights of artists. Don't steal. This is also why making your own custom backgrounds is better than, let's say, creating a room in The Sims. Because technically, EA owns the copyright to all the assets used in the game. So if you take a screenshot and slap it into your comic, you could theoretically get in trouble. Now, is anyone realistically going to notice if that's what you did? Probably not, but it's better to be safe than sorry. First things first, enabling the add-on. Go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and then either search for Blender Kit or scroll until you find it. I'm using version 4.1 of Blender, so if you're using a newer version, some things might look a bit different. Once it's enabled, you'll see this little search bar show up. From here, the fun stuff begins. I will be using both Archimesh and Blender Kit to create a cafe scene I need for my webtoon. And I suppose this is the part where I have to come clean. The Blender footage I recorded for this is actually really, really old at this point. I needed a cafe for chapter 26 on my webtoon Even When the Sun Doesn't Shine, and I've already finished drawing chapter 39, so this video has been in the drafts for a long time. Like my whole channel, honestly, but better late than never, am I right? You should go read it, by the way. My webtoon, that is. I only have 4,000 subscribers, and I need more. Well, need is a strong word for it, but I just think it would be nice if more people could find it since Webtoon seems to hate my work. Back to the tutorial. First things first, it's hard to decorate a room without a room, so I'll quickly put up some walls using the Archimesh add-on. If this seems like black magic to you, go check out my video where I talk about it in more detail. Archimesh makes it really easy to create walls, doors, and certain types of windows. Once the walls are in a place where I like them, I create a plane for the floor and make sure it's roughly the same shape as the room itself. One of the main visions I had for this cafe is that it has really big windows along one of the walls. So let me finally properly show you the godsend that is the Blender Kit add-on. So I need a window, right? I go to the search bar, I type window, press enter, and bada bing bada boom, I got a whole list of windows to choose from. From here, I can just browse for what I want and then drag it into my scene. Also, if you go on this little button, you can make sure to sort by free items first. Because yes, you can buy assets on here if you really want to, and it's a great way to support artists that take time to make them for us. But we're all cheapskates here, aren't we? Now we have a window. Lovely. What else do we need in a cafe? Well, we'll probably need some cute little signs, some pastries, cups and plates. And let's not forget that the customers need some place to sit. For that, we need tables and chairs. So how do we get all those things? We type it into the little search bar, of course. You can type keywords like cute or cafe, or you can write the kind of item you want, like chair or table. From here, you just gotta find stuff that fits the vibe you're going for. It's also pretty similar to decorating in The Sims. It's also important to note that it's not just objects that you can bring into your scene. You can also find good materials to use through the Blender kit. Here I found a cute material that I thought would fit nicely as a floor for my little cafe, so I just dragged that right on in there. And a nice tip, if you don't like the way the floorboards are going, you can just go ahead and rotate the UV map. While you're at it, you can scale the UVs up or down to make the floorboards bigger or smaller. Just make sure you're in the material or render mode to be able to see what you're doing. And it was at this point that I decided I didn't want the windows to sit awkwardly on the side of the wall, so I cut out some holes for them using Boolean modifiers on the wall itself. Now the windows can be moved so they are in the wall, which looks much nicer and more natural. The entire rest of the process goes along those same lines. Search for what you want, drag it in, and there you have it! It's in your scene now. The only limit is your imagination and maybe the specs of your computer. I will say that not all assets are made equal. If something slows down your computer, you're probably better off deleting it and finding another asset. As a game developer, it pains me sometimes to see the ungodly amount of geometry that people decide to use on things, but let's not get too deep into that. As much as I've been worshipping this add-on for the past, I don't even know how many minutes, there are certain limits. Sometimes you don't find anything that matches your vision, and that's okay. If you made it this far, you probably have the skills to make it yourself. For example, here I modeled the counter myself, because I didn't see anything that struck my fancy or fit the vision I was going for. The good thing is that I can still use the Blender kit to find materials to use on the counter I made. And hey, that still saves me a lot of time. Once I finally felt pleased with how I decorated my cafe, the scene was lagging quite badly. And honestly, that's my fault because I went a little crazy with all the details that no one's ever going to see. And there's still one final step before we can actually use this scene that we made in our comics, and that's to add some lighting. I'll be honest and say that when I made this cafe, well over a year ago, I never actually played around much with Blender's lighting, so it looks a little gloomy and meh. But I already knew I'd be fixing it later on to match my drawings anyways, so it didn't really matter. You can do all kinds of things to get a good render, like playing with ambient occlusion, bloom, different colored lights, etc, etc, but in my case, I didn't get to render anything at all because I think I put in too much stuff, so Blender just kept crashing on me when I tried to render an image. In the end, I settled for taking a screenshot of the scene when it was open in Blender and called it a day. And you know what? It's not like it matters much anyways. It's just a background. I've saved these screenshots I took for nearly a year now, just so I could show you guys the results. And I'm happy to soon be able to delete them from my computer, because I'm always running low on storage space because I installed the Oblivion remake. Haven't played it in months, by the way, but it took me 2 days to install, so I refused to get rid of it. These screenshots are what I actually used as the backgrounds for chapter 26 on my webtoon. And yes, it was only for that one chapter. I don't think I'll ever use it as a background again, but I know for a fact I still saved time by making a 3D model instead of drawing all of these different perspectives, because the whole process only took me 2.5 hours, including the long break I took in the middle to go eat dinner. Is it the perfect solution for every background need you might have? Maybe, maybe not. I don't know what your needs are. But I will say that I still have some tips and tricks up my sleeve when it comes to 3D backgrounds for comics, so consider subscribing if you want to hear more. If you found this video helpful, give it a like! And yeah, if you're still here, go read my story Even When the Sun Doesn't Shine on Webtoon, join my Patreon, or go play MISTWINTER on Steam. Good game!